time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. You know just where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to follow my Instagram. That's Geekly Amanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. So follow me there too. And let's get this review started. Alright, y'all. If you haven't watched HBO's series Made for Love, you are missing out. Because it is such a fun, quirky, kind of sci-fi series where I have to just say, expect the unexpected in this one. So let me tell you a little bit about it. So the series centers around Hazel, who is married to tech mogul Byron Gogol and has been living with him inside a custom-made hub for the last 10 years. Well, Byron's latest invention, called Made for Love, is a chip he implants in her brain to achieve total like-mindedness. After a dinner party, when he announced Hazel and himself planned to be the first couple implanted with the chip, Hazel escapes the hub and is on the run. Made for Love stars what's her name, Kristen Milioti, and you also may have recognized her from Palm Springs, which she does great. You know, Billy Magnuson, who also plays the Byron Gogol, them two together have great chemistry. But this also stars Ray Romano. He plays Hazel's dad, and let me tell you, he is the best character in this. Not only did he play like a kind of disconnected dad when she was young because he lost his wife and kind of got into drinking, but she's been disappeared for 10 years now. She's on the run. She goes to her dad, and now her dad has a relationship with a sex doll. Yes, you heard me right. A sex doll. Acting's great. You have Ray Romano and his little sex dog. Like, he has a real relationship. He calls her Diane. He brings her places. He gives her food, like, every morning. You know, serves her own plate of food. He is just so great in this role. You know, she is, too. You know, the chemistry she has with first the father-daughter relationship with her and Ray. But also, you know, the clashing between her and the Byron. He plays, you know, Byron Gogol. He's the antagonist of this. And he is the character you love to hate. But also, you know, he gave his character so many layers to it. You love to hate him, but you also, by the end, you feel some sort of sadness, you know, towards him. He gives it a lot of humanity, his character. Now, Made for Love is definitely quirky. It has, like, this dark humor. But also, you know, the underlining meaning of it. Gogol character can kind of be related to like a Mark Zuckerberg or Elon Musk. And just think of his name, his last name and company name Gogol, which kind of is, you know, a play on Google. He lives in this hub, which could be totally symbolic of, you know, the hub we all live in when we're in our electronics and kind of zone out everything. It really is a great reveal of what our life and, you know, so encompassed with technology could lead to, this isolated type of. Let's get down to the Parents Guide review, which they have a lot of strong language used, profanity. You get words like, you know, the F word, the S word, the P word, the D word. So there is some lookout language in this. Violence, they have a little bit of violence. There's a character that gets his fingers chopped off in this. There's also some gun wielding, and one of the characters gets shot. Not extreme violence, but you do see some. And sexual content. The sexual content in this is kind of high. I mean, you have a guy who has a sex doll, so he kind of gets caught in the act sometimes. He gets asked questions about how it feels with the sex doll. There's a little bit of nudity, some naked bottoms, some naked butts. And, you know, there are scenes where they show some masturbation till the masturbation to full orgasm. So that the sex content's up there. So I enjoyed this series. It had the twist turns. It was unpredictable. You couldn't guess what was going to happen by the end of this. I'm telling you, if you do, you're a genius. You know, so if you've watched it, let me know what you think. Comments, thumbs, all that. Until next time, y'all. Mwah. Bye.